A universal state of emergency within which to work on our land and make this happen for everyone. I saw that all people, our people around the world were in urgent need of help. Some have died waiting for the payouts, some have lost trust, while others have become our own enemies, skeptics and critics. Others have lost their homes and properties, while others were facing imprisonment, etc. Everyone was sacrificing to help us complete things quickly and pay them out. In every country, our officers were affected adversely by the wrong way. It's not just 1 or 2 years waiting, but more than 2 decades, or 21 years to be specific. It's half of what Israel went through from Egypt to the Promised Land. Israel did it in 40 years, we did it in 21 years. 21 years is 347, which is 7 plus 7 plus 7. We can't wait for another 20 years because I don't have an associate cadet to take over from me. I'm the only one who started the journey and the only one who must take you to the Promised Land. That's how and why we commenced our own corporate farm here in Tonu City. I thank all of you who sacrificed and worked hard to plant all kinds of foods in our own corporate farm. As explained in my recent speech, the farm has 3 components. First component is normal traditional food like alcohol, taro, tapioca, etc. Second component is rice farming. And third component is protein farming like poultry, cattle, fish, bakery for those who eat pork, and so on. So far, only 1 component has been farmed. The other 2 components have not been fully added yet. From now on, we must make sure that all 3 components are included to completion. The food is a foundational survival requirement in any human society, both traditional or modern. Therefore, even though we now have big farms ready for our use, let's not forget to plant our own rural farms or gardens. As a system, we must have big farms here in Tonu City, in Siwai, or South Bougainville, North and Central Bougainville, then to our communities here, Pacific, and the rest of the world. Wherever on the planet where the system or run is located, everything we do must start from our own farming or gardening. Therefore, when you go back home, make enough land available for the system to make gardens or big corporate farms. Even at your own personal level, don't let your millions of money blindfold you to thinking that farming is not important for you. It's all good for all of us. Now, I'm saying this because very soon, as our payout reaches step 3, most people will be blinded by their monies and will be buying just about anything they see on the shop counters. Let us be aware that all imported foods, like tinned fish, or tinned meat, etc., have preservatives or chemicals in them. Therefore, we must have our own organic foods taken directly from our own gardens or farms. The system was or is established to provide an opportunity where people can live very long lives, even forever. That can be achieved if we take into account every area of our lives, spirit, soul, and body. As for food, the system will make sure to stop all imported foodstuff like tinned fish or corned beef, etc. There was an urgent need to declare a universal state of emergency. Immediately following my declaration, we started our rural farm and everyone in Kings Square worked tirelessly until the farm was ready to supply us our daily foods, food needs, and we'll be back here in no time to commence our reconstruction and infrastructure development programs. The other group from India is still sorting out other arrival visas with PNG and will be here soon as their visas are processed. We are now all aware that whatever millions they bring to Bougainville will be directly converted into our local and national currency, BBK, on the ground at our fixed exchange rate. This is because everything on the ground will be done exclusively in BBK. Now, I'm repeating all this to stress the fact that we are in a universal state of emergency. We broke through because of this universal state of emergency that forced you to work on the ground with your hands rather than just waiting for me. Therefore, in closing our 40 Days 40 Nights program, I'm also opening our universal payout to be conducted without a universal, within a universal state of emergency. Let me give you an insight. Now, some years ago, when I was still in Solomon Islands, I saw a dream, a vision of how things would happen for a breakthrough. In the dream, a vision, I saw all the countries of the world waiting at the gate. They all came with their submissions and were standing around the gates outside the fence. They were waiting to be called in. The gates were locked, closed and locked. After a while, I also came to the venue with my application submission. As soon as I arrived at the gates, a voice from inside instructed the guards to open the gate for me to enter. The word was, open the gate for him. His case is an emergency. So I just drove into the palace and got shoved ahead of everyone else. Then I saw everyone just began to complain. They were saying, hey, this guy just came now and they let him in. How it's not fair. We've been waiting here at the periphery of the gates for ages and still have not been allowed in yet. In response to the complaints, those inside the palace were saying, this guy's case is very urgent, this emergency. His case is very, very urgent. Much more urgent than all your cases. Therefore, we must serve him first. Emergency is priority. That's how the dream ended. The vision. Ladies and gentlemen, that's true. Emergency is always a top priority in every situation and circumstance. As I said above, our breakthrough came because the universal state of emergency we declared in Charleston, April this year. Let us keep working within the state of emergency mindset to continue seeing our breakthroughs every day. The situation we are in now is an emergency. Not only here, but all over the world, even in your families, communities, districts, provinces, and countries, there are emergencies needing urgent attention. There's no more control in our societies under the PHAVG system. Alcohol and marijuana have permeated and taken hold of families. Everywhere you go, you see people drinking beer, dancing, and ending up in fights, skirmishes, killing each other, etc., etc. More than 20% of road accidents are caused by beer and marijuana consumption. Here in Bougainville, I hear marijuana-affected drug bodies in Buka walking naked on the streets and picking up dead frogs or rock frogs and eating them. They've lost the sense of living and can do anything that a normal human being cannot do. That is an emergency, but people don't want to talk about it because they don't see it as an urgent case needing to be fixed. There are emergencies everywhere, in your own families, maybe your own children are caught up in drinking beer or marijuana and you don't do anything, you couldn't do anything to stop it because you don't have the capacity. Even in your own churches, there are emergencies needing to be addressed. People have got used to seeing them, that they don't see them as critical emergencies anymore. I can go on and on enumerating all the emergencies I see, but time and space doesn't allow me to do so. Every day, there are people dying from all kinds of preventable diseases, sicknesses, etc. That's also an emergency. When I was in Port Moresby, I would also go to Morocco and see street beggars sitting on the sides with plates, asking for donations of money, etc. I saw that it's an emergency and wanted to find a solution for them. I realized that the solution is in money. Without money, I cannot help them. Therefore, when I started doing this back in 1998, the first people I managed to expatriate from the streets were street beggars. I gave them more than enough money that they soon left the streets and went home. Some bought their own homes and second-hand vehicles and never returned to the streets. Others returned to the streets when I left Port Moresby for Australia or Solomon Islands or returned to Bougainville. Everywhere I went, I interviewed or interrogated people, prostitutes, rascals, criminals, unemployed people, homeless people, etc. I saw the circumstances as emergencies. They all said, if we had money, we wouldn't be doing all these things. That to me was an emergency too. I can go on and on, but maybe the above is enough to stress that we are truly in a universal state of emergency. That's the reason why the then PNG Prime Minister BSK, when asked by Parliament why he was investing with this Buka guy, he said, this black guy is doing something that I cannot do. I was born and grew up on the streets but have never seen anyone cleaning up the streets from beer, alcohol, marijuana, prostitution, etc. This is the first time I've seen someone cleaning up the streets and squatter settlements single-handedly. Ladies and gentlemen, we are daily bombarded by various critical issues of emergency from every area or angle of life. Let us all rise up now to clean up our societies, families, communities, schools, churches, etc., etc. Again, I'm stressing this to make you realize that the universal state of emergency I declared in Chalcedony or April this year has not expired yet. Although I did not continue to contribute formally, I still maintain it on my own as I'm still in the state of emergency to give you and all my investors to clients the long awaited payouts. I'm trying to force you, your brain, to think emergency, that this is not a normal situation. Even the 15 years that the world gave to Bougainville is expiring next year on 15 June 2020. In other words, we have, if we really claim to be free, independent, sovereign, we must start talking, taking over the funding of all government services now this year. It's another state of emergency for us. And at my level of leadership, all I see everywhere now is emergencies needing urgent attention from me. That's exactly how I saw things before I started Uvistract in 1998. That's exactly how I'm seeing again things when I'm commencing my payouts now. God, our Father in Heaven, has released us now to conduct our payouts because everywhere is a state of emergency, needing our urgent help, just as I saw in the dream visited many years ago. The dream of arrival in Tonu City, promised land. Now, some years before I came back to Tonu, I saw a dream, a vision. I was traveling along the bush track on a bicycle, or sometimes it would seem to be a tracker. It was a long journey. Finally, I saw myself coming through the track along the Tonu High School, then came past the Tonu Maternity Ward, and then down to the Tonu Primary School outside, then crossing the Kutuna Creek, and then up to the side of the church, and all the way where my office is located now. I was standing around there, but was still thinking that I had not reached Tonu yet. It was only after looking back and seeing the primary school, maternity ward, and so on, that I realized that I had already arrived. I marveled and became so overjoyed. Now, from the dream of vision, I got the revelation that this is exactly how our fight of freedom, independence, and sovereignty will be. Most people will be thinking that we are still autonomous under PNG or United Nations. They will not realize that we are already free, independent, and sovereign until they look back at the process we followed. The same applies to our payouts. We already graduated on the 30th of August, June 2019, 2 months ago. That's when we crossed over the finishing line. That's also when we crossed over Jordan and stepped on the promised land. Then on the 8th of Jasper, July, we merely activated our system with full power and full authority. Then on the 1st of Sapphire, August, this month, we commenced our BBK Township Convention Payout Program on the ground. Then we invited our international investment groups from Asia to come to the ground and exchange with the large foreign currency funds, converting into BBK of Bougainville. We started step two recently and progressing slowly. Currently, residents of King Square have been paying for the daily rice requirements from trade stores. We will be adding other components of step two following my speech today. We may also add the church group living outside the King Square, so they may also buy their rice and BBK until a corporate farm is ready to supply other kinds of food, chicken, rice, protein, etc. The more we work hard in planting our corporate farms and gardens, the better it will take to shape us at the basic foundational level. Our Asian Chinese investors have not arrived back in China yet. Due to the cancellation of flights in Boca and Europa, they did not catch their flights back, but they might be flying today via Europa on the same flight that our Iran President Tom Shanwawi will be flying. When they arrive back home, the funds they deposited into my account will become withdrawable, so we can move faster through the steps 2 and 3. I tried to squeeze all 3 steps within the 16 days and succeeded to some degree, I just need to add the remaining components to step two after the speech so we can move quickly and to step three soonest. Now, from the way we are moving, we reach step three well before the end of the month. It's still good news. Though we couldn't reach step three by today as originally expected on the closing day, but we are encouraged by the fact that real things are happening. We can all see it happening. We are not just sitting in idle and talking. Real things are happening, and we'll get through step two faster and reach step three before the end of the month. My speech today will not be very long. It's harvest time now, so I'll just summarize things here and bring things to conclusion. Now, conclusion. In closing, let me just quickly highlight to you some breaking news that happened yesterday and the day before. The little ceremony and my speech on Christmas Day, Sunday, welcoming our Asian business tycoons or investors to Tonu City was recorded by some of our soldiers and residents of Tonu City. One of them was Bosman. I happened to get one of the copies from General Maroni and sent to some of my people, our people in Bougainville, PNG, Solomon Islands, West Papua, Australia, Asia, Europe, Africa and America. Since they were asking for updates, I decided to just send them the clip from my WhatsApp and Skype. Now, surprisingly, the little clip went viral on the international scene among millions of our clients and investors. Then someone from Europe and US with US connections asked for permission to send it to the President Trump of America and the Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. I gave him the okay. So a little later, the word came to me that both countries now want to recognize Bougainville under your leadership. Wow! I did not expect things to happen that fast. I thought it would take a little while, but to my surprise, both countries now want to recognize us just like that. The little video clip has convinced them because they can see major Chinese business tycoons coming to invest with us. They could also see from the clip how I stated that the PNG-ABG governance system has lost control of our Bougainville and that it was now time for the Royal Twin Kingdoms of Papua and Macau to take over. The other thing that really convinced them is the sure fact that our unborrowed and sovereign currency is now trading locally. We can buy any type of food from a gardens, corporate farms, etc. We can also buy rice from the stores and all the other components which we are in the process of providing. Also, since April this year, we've been deducting rentals, bills for GST, for all government services, education, medical, electricity, Wi-Fi communication, etc., etc. All this and many more proofs that our currency VVK is already traded on the ground. Therefore, big countries are now requesting to recognize us. We are no longer asking them to recognize us. No, things are turned around now. They themselves are calling and requesting to recognize us because our system is now operational on the ground where it really matters. This is what has been lacking in Bougainville over the years. Most of our leaders since 1975 have been making UTIs and trending back to PNG within days or weeks. The reason why they keep surrendering to PNG after every UTI was because they did not create a sovereign system for themselves. They wanted independence without first recognizing themselves. The fact of the matter is that no one can recognize you unless you first recognize yourself. The level of recognition from other countries depends on our own level of existence, performance, or sovereignty. If we regard ourselves as autonomous, other countries will also recognize us as autonomous. If we recognize ourselves as free, independent, sovereign, that's exactly how other countries will also recognize us. That's what's happening now. Since we recognize ourselves as free, independent, and sovereign, other countries will also recognize us in the same way. This is simple wisdom. Simple logic, simple reasoning, which has evaded our leaders all this time. As you can see, the reason why ABG will forever remain subservient to PNG and Australia, World Bank, IMF, UN, etc., is because ABG leaders recognize themselves as autonomous puppets. They have been merely begging for recognition without setting up anything on the ground for themselves to convince the international community. Well, I can assure you 100% that we are going to hijack the so-called PNG-MBG peace process and bring back our people back to sanity. They have gone insane. They have gone insane. Must be brought back to normalcy. Just as the bargaining process was hijacked by its financiers and lenders, we are going to do the same. We will hijack it back and bring our group people back to normalcy. During the insanity, they sold our island Bougainville for up to 9.7 million kina. Our turn has now come to either repay that foreign debt or just bring our good people back to normalcy and arise together as a free, independent, and sovereign people. Finally, in closing, let me remind us that the three steps of currency conversion are not separate. They all work together. Even after we reach step three, full international convertibility and trade, later this month, we will not do away with steps one and two. No. Step one is farming or gardening as well, as you know. It cannot be done away with. Step one will remain as we will keep making and extending our farms and gardens around the islands. There are thousands of unemployed people who are on standby to come from many nations to work in our farms, on our farms. As explained recently, any farm worker from Malaysia or India or wherever we bring them will come with passports and visas and will return after 6 to 8 months of work. They won't stay here for too long. Of course, those involved with long-term projects can stay longer or on business visas. In this way, we will control the movement of people in and out of Bougainville, just as other independent nations do. So my final point in closing today is to remind us that we are already in the promised land of making honey. In terms of our software, we crossed on the 30th of June, or I mean this 2019. We already crossed each other. It has been 2 months now since we arrived. Now, in terms of political destiny, we became independent on May 17, 1990. In terms of financial destiny, we became independent on 21st April 2000. In terms of our sovereignty, we became sovereign on the 16th of August 2008, on this day. Therefore, it's our time to plant and reap rich harvest right here in the promised land where we now live. As for our governors from PNG, West Papua, SI, and Fiji, get ready to return to your respective countries with full hands. Today we are closing our 40 days, 40 nights ceremony. However, I'm opening again our universal celebrations beginning today. You will go back home now and organize your own 40 days, 40 nights program. You will have big plans to stage it. My very last final word is to keep your eyes open. I'm receiving some funds, withdrawing some funds today. Other funds will be withdrawn next week in Gregorian calendar. I might begin tomorrow, Saturday, to add the other components to our step two program. Just keep your eyes open and wait for tomorrow's program. Let's be excited, because step two will ultimately take us to step three even before you wink your eyes. The banks, the UV banks will be open 6 days a week, except rest day Sabbath, for anyone client who may go for inquiries, check his accounts, and so on. So the bank will be open if you want to do any inquiries there. It has not been open for some time because due to all kinds of issues. But it will be open from now on 6 days a week. So thank you very much for everyone for your listening ears. Thank you.